So I just finished reading Everyone Has a Story by Savi Sharma. I picked it up because it got so many amazing reviews on Goodreads and Amazon. And it was also a bestseller on Amazon since eternities. So yeah, I just had to read it. And okay, now that I'm done reading it, I have only one thing to say to Savi Sharma. I'm a huge fan, you know, I'm a huge fan.
I'm a big fan of your work, a ceiling fan of your work, like a stool, a rope and a ceiling fan.
Throughout the fucking book, I was like, logic kahan hai? There's no logic in the book. I mean, how can a book be so bad and yet be a bestseller? But wait, I already made a video on it, na? So just go and check it out. But yeah, the book is really, really bad and it has no logic whatsoever. She tries really hard to make the book good with some profound and lovely sentences, but she does not make it beautiful at all because it has no meaning or no sense in it whatsoever. And even though I'm a literature student, I really think that books should at least have a little bit of a logic to be best-selling books. So yeah. Everyone Has a Story is a story about four people apparently, but actually it's about two people called Meera and Vivan. The other two characters, well, I just did not understand that they were protagonists until and unless I just saw another review and realized that, okay, they are also characters in this book as protagonists. And then I realized that if they are also protagonists, this book does not really have any side characters at all. So the book is totally about these four people. Actually two, the rest of them are just like, just there for no reason at all. No reason whatsoever. They're just there. So the book opens with Meera, who is an aspiring writer. Good. She's an aspiring writer. She has not found a story as yet. But when she attends a session of an author, she finds this man who says that he wants to travel. And she finds her story. Wow. Amazing. You have spent over 20 years of your life in the search of a story. You didn't find it. One freaking man just came and said that he wants to travel. You got your story. I mean, why have you never heard anybody else wishing to travel? Are you really, really insane, or did you just get interested in this guy's story because he was good looking? I think the second one is the case. Absolutely, that's the case. Also, what also kind of struck me is that the author in whose session she went, the author picked her up among the whole crowd and asked, "What's your story?" She says that, "I want to be a writer like you." And the author is kind of philosophizing things and she's like, "Okay, I want to be an author." The author is like, "You as an author should be telling lies, good lies and bad lies." And then he says that, "Your lies are good. You have just met this girl. You picked her up among the whole crowd. I think you are very perverted, because ideally an author should say if anyone in the crowd is interested in sharing their story and then let the one who wants to speak come up." But he particularly picks up Meera, obviously, because she has an angelic face. And then he says that, "Your lies are good lies. You have not read her stories. How do you know that?" No logic. And then she finds out this guy called Vivan in this same session and she wants to know his story. What's his story? No story at all. His only story that I could apparently get from the book was that he lost a parent when he was very young. I don't even remember which was it, a mother or a father. But anyway, I don't give a damn, because it either way does not have a story. Because so many people lose their parents when they are very young and they don't seek as much attention than this guy is seeking. Now, Vivan wanted to travel, but he did not travel until and unless he met Meera, and that again has no reason at all. He had no bonds to share, no responsibilities whatsoever to count on. He could have traveled before meeting Meera, but he goes on to travel after meeting Meera, leaving her heartbroken, obviously. Also, something that really strikes me, that Meera met Vivan for the first time as a stranger, and then she speaks to him like they have been in a relationship for years. She's hugging this stranger. She's letting him hold her hand. I mean, girl, this is India. what about your safety? You should really, really keep a check on your behavior with strangers. You know, you might get in some real trouble someday if you keep behaving like this. And if that was not enough, Meera sends Vivan a text message which goes something like this: I'm going to handcuff you to a table so that you cannot run. 50 Shades of Grey alert. And it also reminded me of something else.
Hi.
How are you?
But okay, I really thought that Meera was too easily impressed, and there were points in the book that you just felt like, what's this? I mean, she just wrote anything that came to her mind, anything. Even I can now tell a story. You know, when I was very small, I used to live outside Kolkata. My story is so sad that when I was not living in Kolkata, my great-grandmother died and my birthday was not celebrated. So sad. I had to travel from Kolkata to Bhubaneswar and Bhubaneswar to Kolkata twice every year. So hectic, so damn troublesome. It's such a sad story. I think my story will become a bestseller now though, because I have just told you my story and everyone has a story. But everyone has a story really does not have a story, as quoted by Manpreet in her video. So yeah, I really, really remember that. Another logic alert: in this book, when this guy called Vivan goes to travel, every effing person he meets is just telling him about love and how to grab love and how he should not let go of love. Every freaking person, from Spanish to Chinese to Indian to Japanese, everybody is saying the same freaking thing. I mean, how do they know that he has left someone behind? How? And why are they speaking about only one thing, the same thing, across the whole world? I mean, no logic whatsoever. The end of this book, well, it was so predictable that I just don't want to talk about it. The thing is, the only reason the book became a bestseller was extreme marketing gimmicks. Whenever I opened my Facebook account, I would see an ad of this book, which was publicized as a romantic inspirational read. Well, if you want to commit suicide, then this is a very inspirational read for you. So make sure that you grab it in case you want to find out an easy way to kill yourself. So yeah, this was my review for Everyone Has a Story. In case you like good construction of sentences, then maybe this book may interest you. But in all other cases, I'll say don't grab this book. In case you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to comment with your comment on the book in case you have read it, or in case you haven't, you have watched the review. How did you like this review, or you didn't? Just let me know. And make sure that you subscribe to my channel, because I'll be back with another video next week. Till my next video, bye bye. Well, I picked up that book because that book, but she has not found a story as yet. She's a writer. She's an aspiring writer who wants to be a writer. The thing is, everyone has a story. Could have been such a great, better story if it was just worked on more.